Hey, what's up? My name is Austin, and today I'm going to show how I would learn to code if I was to start over, part 2. In part 1 of the series, I talked about where to start and how to learn coding. But now that hopefully you have begun to familiarize yourself with coding, I want to share more practical steps to how you can go from a person who is just learning how to code into a person who is able to code at a level where companies are looking to hire. I'll break this video down into two parts. First, I'll share about what languages and coding concepts you should familiarize yourself with when learning to code. And second, I'll talk about what projects to build in order to make yourself more marketable to tech companies. Now, what language would I recommend when starting? If you want to take the traditional software engineering path, I recommend learning a language such as Python or Java, as those are generally the foundational languages to many software applications, and generally many intro classes at the university level will start off with these. Also, these are the two most common languages for technical interviews, so just being comfortable with one of these two would be ideal. If I had to choose between Python and Java, I would definitely recommend Python because the syntax is personally more clean, but you really can't go wrong with either. I won't go into too much detail on how to learn Python or Java here, but some basic concepts you need to understand are variables, data types, if-else statements, and loops. These should be pretty straightforward and are really just explaining the syntax of the language. Once you master those, try to learn more complex computer science concepts such as data structures, algorithms, and object-oriented programming. At this point, you don't need to master these concepts in order to build something, so I wouldn't worry too much if it's hard to understand initially. But as long as you're familiar with the syntax of the language, you're ready to at least learn how to build software. Another concept you need to be familiar with when learning to code is the process of compiling. Normally when we think of coding, it's writing a few lines of code and then letting it run and something will happen, such as a calculation will occur or something will show up on the web page. But how does the computer know how to read your code? That's where compiling comes in. It converts your code from something like you can read into English into something like assembly code, which is something the computer can understand. I remember when I first started coding in Java, before the code would execute, I had to compile the code before I could run it. And in essence, this was a safety check to make sure the code is workable before it could actually execute. Another concept you need to be familiar with when learning to code is debugging. So many times when you learn to code, you're going to make a lot of mistakes. You know, I personally almost made every mistake you can make when learning to code, whether it's basic syntax errors such as spelling words wrong, forgetting a semicolon, or not closing a quote. Debugging is really going to make the difference in terms of saving time, because I remember when I first started, I barely knew how to debug, so when an error would occur, I wouldn't be able to find where this error was, which again caused a lot of restless nights. From a high level, to debug well, you need to be able to know things such as reading the line numbers when you make mistakes, to use the inspect element tool in Chrome if you're building in a web, or use a debugger in your code editor, or just be able to Google Stack Overflow when you encounter an unfamiliar error. I know it sounds sort of elementary right now, but just knowing these tools is going to save so much time when learning how to code. Okay, so now that you have some languages under your belt, now it's time to use that code and build something, because that's how you're going to show companies you know how to really code. Personally, I think the best place to start learning how to code is building a website. Why, you may ask? Well, first, websites are extremely easy and practical. You know, everyone knows what a website is, but also the tools and resources are abundant online compared to other types of coding projects at the moment. And once you know how to build websites, you'll be able to create a portfolio to share with people and other companies your ability to code, so that's just another plus. So when it comes to building a website, it's built into two parts. Front end, which is known as the client side, and back end, which is known as the server side. Front end is what you see. It's the layout of the webpage. It's the color and size of the text. It's also where you see cool interactive visual effects when you're on a web page. Backend is the part of the website where the data or content is connected to the web page, usually via a database. To code in the front end, the first two languages you need to learn is HTML and CSS. Now granted, these aren't the typical programming languages, but what I like about them is that they're extremely easy to learn, and because they're the foundational languages of building websites, this makes coding in these really easy. Because now you'll be able to immediately see what you're coding. When I began learning HTML and CSS, I just went through some basic tutorials on Codecademy, but after a few days, I could immediately start building a static web page, which at the time just seemed incredible. Once you can build a static web page, the next thing you want to learn is JavaScript. JavaScript is a scripting or programming language that allows you to implement complex features on web page. Some examples you may encounter from JavaScript are hover effects or speed scroll. So anyway, these will make your websites look dynamic and modern. Once you get down these basics, We realized that there are frameworks and libraries that will help you reproduce websites faster, such as Bootstrap for CSS and jQuery and React for JavaScript. I won't continue going into more detail because learning those frameworks can be another video in itself. But from a high level, a lot of companies do use React in their stack. So if you're able to learn these frameworks, you'll be setting up yourself to be very marketable. Now that you're finished building the front end, it's important to learn the back end of a website. To do so, you'll need a server-side language, which means a language that can communicate with the database. The server-side language I would recommend to learn is Node.js, since that is the most modern server-side language, but it also wouldn't hurt to learn PHP as well, as it still powers most websites of the internet. Now with these languages under your belt, you'll actually be able to build a basic website and even web applications such as a Yelp or Instagram. Personally, if I was starting today, I would look for a tutorial on these subjects on Free Code Camp because they'll literally walk you step by step on how to set up your environment, which trust me, is so much more helpful than reading documentation. In this setup, you'll also probably learn how to use the terminal, which although it looks really intimidating and outdated, it really is just a faster way to move directories than the traditional GUI. I personally walked through a lot of these tutorials when I first began learning how to build websites and web applications. In doing so, it gave me the confidence to say, wow, I actually built a website or application that someone could actually use. Once you begin to get more comfortable, I'd make slight modifications to these projects that you learn, and eventually we would start customizing it to something that you're more passionate about. So many applications share the same features, such as authenticating users, creating profiles, that you realize whatever you need, especially today, there's probably a tutorial out there. Next tip I have is, now once you've built out a web application, if you want to show companies your coding chops, you need to upload it to a version control website such as GitHub, which essentially links your local project into a cloud so companies can see your code and how you built out your project. But don't worry, you can always password protect your code if you think it's super valuable and you worry that someone will steal it. I don't want to go into all the weeds of how to use all of GitHub here, but some basic commands you need to be familiar with is git add, which tells GitHub what files to push to the cloud, git push, which pushes the files to the cloud, and git pull, which is used to update the local files if the cloud version has been updated. A lot of companies these days now expect to see a GitHub repository, as many companies now ask for it on the job application. So if you have one, you will definitely have a leg up on the rest of your competition. Alright, so once you go through all these steps, you're more than ready to start coding and building products that are going to change the world. The journey of learning coding never ends, and there's always going to be new things to learn. But by going through these steps, I promise you'll have a solid foundation on what it takes to learn and how to code. Best of luck! Thanks for watching today's video. If you like content like this, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. If you're interested in learning how to pass technical interviews to get into tech companies such as Meta, Google, and Apple, be sure to watch this video here. Alright, thanks guys.